Welcome back to Joy Tutorials. Previous I discussed class 7 lesson 1 food components part 1 over part 2 now. Okay, let us do 3. Confirmation of presence of food components. What are the food components? What are the food nutrients? Carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, trace, etc. These are the food components. Confirmation of presence of food components. We have to do experiments. Okay, here first experiment, test for carbohydrates. That's why I take an sample of carbohydrate food item like potato, rice, wheat, maize, noodles, whole wheat pasta, etc. food items. Na? That's why I take noodles. Okay, this is the noodles food item. This is my sample. What are the materials required? Sample, test tube, dilute iodine solution required. That's why I am taking some iodine crystals in a test tube. Okay, I am taking iodine crystals in a test tube. So I am added water drop by drop. It have to turns into yellow or brown color till I added water. It will turn to yellow or brown color means our solution is ready. Dilute iodine solution is ready. So materials required: sample, dilute iodine solution, test tube holder, etc. required. Here I am taking sample in the test tube. This is my food sample. This food noodles is there, na? This I kept in the test tube. Okay. Then I added the dilute iodine solution. Few drops of dilute iodine solution I added. It turns to blue or black color. Okay. So given food sample contains carbohydrates. What contains? Given sample, it contains carbohydrate. Okay, it's proven. Result is blue or black color. That means given sample is carbohydrate food item. Next one, second experiment. Test for fats. That's why here materials required: paper, sample paper, white paper. Okay, sample white paper. That's why I taken this food sample, oily food, cheese food, whatever it may be. I gently press or squeeze. Okay, here I squeeze this food item. It turns to translucent. Here see, translucent. Okay, this we can see the not clear image, whatever light looking but not clear. This is a translucent image. This is about the, what is the result? Paper turns translucent. Okay, it indicates given food sample is a fat food. Next, third experiment. Test for proteins. Here, what are the materials required here? Proteins, sample, copper sulfate solution, sodium hydroxide solution. Okay. So here I require 2% copper sulfate, 10% sodium hydroxide required. That's why I have to prepare 2% copper sulfate. How we can prepare 2% copper sulfate solution? 2 grams of copper sulfate, 100 ml water. Our solution is ready. Next one, 10 grams of sodium hydroxide, 100 ml water. Sodium hydroxide solution also ready. I have prepared 2% sodium copper sulfate, 10 grams of sodium hydroxide solution I prepared. This is about the test for protein materials required. Sample 2% copper sulfate solution, 10% sodium hydroxide solution. Next, here sample food items. I taken this dal, okay? Dal I taken. Whatever moong dal, vara dal, chana dal, that all contains proteins. This all dal contains proteins. So this dal is very hard. That's why I kept here. I make into powder. I make into powder. Then I added 2 drops of water. I make a paste. That paste I kept in test tube. This paste I kept in test tube. Then I added drop by drop 10 drops water. 10 drops water. Sample solution ready. Sample solution I prepared. Sample solution I prepared. Here in the sample solution I am adding the 2% copper sulfate solution. Then that's why I am added 2 drops. Next 10% sodium hydroxide solution. I am added 10 drops of sodium hydroxide solution. Then I shake well. Then after some time I noticed that turn into violet or purple color. Result what? Turns to violet or purple color. Violet or purple color. So given food sample is what? This is a protein. This is a protein. Given food sample is protein. This is about the confirmation of presence of food components in the given food samples. Okay? Thank you.